I really see food and cooking as making your children streetwise about the length of their life and their kids' life. So, you know, I'm in the kind of strange position of meeting inspiring people in health, in the specifics of health, sort of global economics and stuff like that. And, you know, it's you know, this last year was the first year where more people died from obesity and diet-related disease than malnutrition and famine. You know, that's the first ever. That's a big twist in what's going on. And, you know, I know stuff's going to change. All this stuff that we're yapping about, all this business, we're going to get there. It will happen, fact, because it'll have to, with a rising population and the shortage of water. But I think for me personally, it's really about how and when. And classically, is it going to have to get so bad before we make the big choices to sort of push forward? So I think schools have done an amazing job in the last 5-6 years on adjusting and doing a better job. I think standards have gone up definitely across the board. I think some schools have done amazingly well, and that's normally come down to a great head cook and a pioneering head teacher, and hopefully both. But there's still a lot to be done. And I think, you know, you still, I guess from the big picture, you want the most hardest to reach kids, the most at risk, to be looked after efficiently. So I think there's a lot to be done. And I think with the Leon boys coming on board now, they've been doing a really good job. I'm completely in support of what they're doing. And hopefully in the next, I don't know, month or two, there's going to be some pioneering commitments from Mr. Gove about what we do for the next 5 years.